Not all data analysts come from a traditional tech background. In fact, many data analysts today come from diverse backgrounds not even related to computer science. Part of this is due to the habits that they've created that has allowed them to change their careers. It's the daily habits that they've formed that has allowed them to be so successful. I've tried a lot of these habits and implemented them into my own life, and this has allowed me to double my salary as a data analyst, be more productive, and not waste my energy on the wrong things. And today I'll be sharing with you what these habits are so that you can start them too. Write down your goals. Research shows that there is a correlation between writing down your goals and earning more money. In 1979, Harvard MBA graduates were asked about their goal-setting habits, and the different approaches that they took really impacted how much money they earned later in their life. 84% of them had no goals, whereas 13% of them had goals but didn't write them down, and the 3% had goals, written them down, and had a clear plan for them. 10 years later, the same people were surveyed, and this was the result. The 13% that had goals but didn't write them down were making twice as much as the graduates who never had goals, while the 3% that had clear goals and an action plan were making 10 times more than the 97% combined. Writing down your goals is so important, but also having a plan that is realistic and achievable. I think when I first start goal setting, I get really excited and think, okay, I can become a data analyst in 3 months, but you want to choose something that's really realistic that you know you can do on top of your everyday life. This may be 3 months for some of you, whereas it may be 1 year for the rest of you. And what you really want to focus on is choose a plan that you know you can achieve. And if you need some inspiration of a data analyst plan, then I'll link this video here where I go into what I would do. Importance of consistency. In the book Slight Edge by Jeff Olson, he talks about simple little things that we choose to do or not to do have a compounding effect on who we become. And this applies to everything in life, including changing your career. It's overwhelming to think about becoming an expert data analyst overnight, but if you break it down and say, I'm going to practice data analysis for just 10 minutes a day, those 10 minutes don't sound like a lot, but over a year, those 10 minutes will add up and you'll be able to do data analysis on your own. It took me a full year to change my career from a healthcare analyst to a data analyst in tech. It may seem from the outside that I did one thing to be able to change my career, but really, it's because I took months of studying every day, choosing to study on a Saturday instead of seeing friends, and working on projects at work that I knew would help me stand out in these interviews. The key to my career progression was consistency. I didn't see any immediate results from all the studying I did for months, but this habit that I built is what really led me to pivot my career to a data analyst role in tech. And so many people think that your failure or success comes from one big thing, when in reality, it's the small habits that you do every day that impact whether or not you will be successful. Action over analysis. The one thing that has really kept me from growing and keeping me at the same pace year after year was overanalyzing. I waited 2 years before I even changed my career because I knew it was something I wanted, but I was analyzing everything. I was thinking, what would I do? What type of career would I want? Do I want to go to grad school? It's good to think about all these things and have a plan, but what really matters 10 years from now is that you actually did the thing. Even if you don't have it all planned out and you don't know the exact steps to become a data analyst, you will naturally figure it out as you go. When I first started my data analyst journey, I knew I had to learn Excel and SQL, but I didn't know exactly where to start. All I did was just enroll in a class and fill in the gaps as I went along. Just get started. You can always change your path if you need to as you go along. And just by having done some action, you're already so much further than the person who is sitting here overanalyzing it. Push outside your comfort zone. The process of changing your careers is extremely uncomfortable. You have to learn new industry lingo, learn new skills, and then there's the unknown of whether you'll even like this new career. When I was first learning data analysis and learning SQL, all these technical skills were extremely overwhelming for me because my background is in litigation consulting, and I just didn't know what would this career path look like for me, and is this something that I would even enjoy? But it continued to show up every day. I took SQL courses, I practiced interview questions, and I applied for jobs that I didn't even feel qualified for. Each of these times, I felt like I wanted to take two steps back, but I would really push myself, and each time pushing my comfort zone a little further and further. And I noticed that as I did this, opportunities would start opening that weren't there before. And I've come to realize that I need to get comfortable with the uncomfortable. Eventually, these things will become comfortable to you. And this is one of the key habits that has allowed me to change my career to a data analyst. Measure your own success. It's easy when you start your data analyst journey to get sidetracked and start getting discouraged by comparing your progress against somebody else's that seems so much ahead of yours. Our perception of how well we're doing is largely impacted by society's expectations and comparisons. You feel like, oh, I should be getting promoted by now. I should have a steady career by now, whereas I'm now just sitting here still figuring it out. Wayne Dyer says, if you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. If we think differently and look at our own success from the eyes of an individual versus a society, you will see that you are looking at yourself from a completely different lens. What helped me with my data journey is to measure my own success rather than looking at everybody else's. I would write down my goals and every month take time to do a retrospective look at how well I did. And this allowed me to do two things. The first is acknowledge how much I've achieved in that past month. And also, by looking at how much I achieved, I was motivated and I could acknowledge the good work I did and keep going. I think sometimes when you're learning something new, trying a new skill, it just feels like you're chugging along with nothing to show for. But when you take the time to acknowledge your work, to actually look back and say, wow, I can query a SQL database and that is something I couldn't do a month ago, that's motivating and really keeps you going. I hope these habits help you stay on track with your career goals. Please smash the like button and subscribe if you enjoyed this, as it really supports the channel. And if you want to know what a data analyst actually does, I will link the video here, and thank you so much. I will see you there.